Welcome back to EdTech School. Today's topic is about iPads versus Chromebooks. The digital classroom comes with many decisions to make. The most important one may be choosing the right device, fit for your teaching or school objectives. In this video, I will help you make that crucial decision. Afterwards, it's up to you to convince the big boss. The first key point is price. iPads are more expensive than Chromebooks. You can get an iPad for about 500 euros, or you can pay about 200 euros and already have a good and cheap Chromebook. A key reason for schools to pick the more expensive iPad over the cheaper Chromebook is the enormous amount of high-quality apps and books available for the iPads. The iPad was the first tablet to see big adoption in the school markets. So it's natural that developers went to that platform first. The Chromebook is quickly catching up though. iPads are easy to carry around. They are flat and small and fit in every school bag. The touch interface is very intuitive and easy for young children to learn. Chromebooks are larger, weigh more, and usually don't have a touch screen. Of course, it certainly depends on what kind of Chromebook you buy. Another advantage of the iPad is that you can use the iPad while holding. You can go on a trip and take meaningful study pictures. A Chromebook must be used when sitting down. A disadvantage for the iPad is definitely the keyboard. There is no keyboard included, unless you pay extra to get a Bluetooth keyboard. It's not so easy to type long text when using the iPad. The Chromebook does have a keyboard, which is nicer. Next up, the battery life of the device. In order to carry around a tablet, it must have a long-lasting battery. The iPad has one that can last for days. If you use a lot of apps, which you are probably going to do, the iPad should last at least for 8 hours. That is very long in comparison with a typical Chromebook. Of course, it all depends on what kind of Chromebook you buy. A more expensive Chromebook can last 8 hours as well. If you buy a Chromebook because it's cheap, the Chromebook will have to be plugged in a lot. That makes moving around more difficult. Whether the device is intuitive or not is also important. iPads are those things on which preschoolers can jump faster than they can crawl, and on which teenage girls edit their selfies to the perfect profile picture. My point? iPads are very intuitive for young children and are already a part of a teenager's life. With the iPad, you are entering the student's comfort zone. A Chromebook is less intuitive, but is also already a part of a teenager's life. Number 5 is quality. The iPad has an excellent build quality. Therefore, it is more fit for viewing high-resolution photos or using educational apps. The iPad also offers a brighter screen and shows a wider range of accurate colors. Of course, this is reflected in the iPad's higher price. A Chromebook has a cheaper build quality. I know, that doesn't mean they aren't suited for school. You can still do a lot with the Chromebook. What's the device purpose? Well, an iPad is very interactive and is famous for its huge range of apps, but students can comfortably edit documents or write an essay with it. This is a type of desk where a Chromebook shines. It's often said that iPads are more of a consumption device and Chromebooks are better at writing and editing. Is a device easy to manage? That is the seventh key point. Have you ever had a problem with technology that even the IT department couldn't fix? Very frustrating, isn't it? Both iPads and Chromebooks are very nearly immune to viruses, so equally appealing in that aspect. But Chromebooks are much easier to manage than iPads. Chromebook management is built right into the Google Apps admin console on the web. If your school is already using Google Apps for education, it should be very simple to use. The final point I will cover is the shareability. Chromebooks support multiple separate user accounts and therefore can be shared among students. They don't belong to one person. The shareability of the iPad is limited. iPads were traditionally single-user devices. You can of course share one among your students, but you'll see each other's data. However, Apple has improved this with the iOS 9.3 update. It's now possible to add different accounts for students on one iPad. Fair warning though, this capability is only available on recent devices with a lot of memory. So, that was it for this week's video. For a closer look, you can always visit our blog. Thanks for watching.